Hi, I'm Scott Mayer with GunsNameOfMag.com. I'm here with Rob Fancher from Steiner Optics. Rob, we have some very different looking binoculars here. I have a Poro prism and you have a roof prism. Why don't you tell me what is the difference between these two, obvious, other than the obvious appearance?
Sure. Well, originally when binoculars were first developed, they actually had through the lens no prisms in the inside of the binoculars. They were straight barrel. And they were limited in terms of the magnification that could be achieved using that system.
And the prism folds the light so that you can have an overall length like this instead of
optical
like
engineers
that.
Back in the 30s or in earlier found out that they could come up with prisms inside here that would actually bend the light and bring it through the objective lens twice down here and thus lengthening the focal length of the light pattern.
So if we go 2 inches, 2 inches, 2 inches, it's the same as if we'd had a 6-inch or thereabouts.
In effect, that's correct. That's correct. Subsequent to that, they found that this kind of binocular was large, heavier, and bulky, and less popular with many people. And about, 40 years ago, 50 years ago, they developed, almost simultaneously, a number of companies developed the roof prism, which actually has an extra set of prisms in it that cause the light to come in, and then it's broken this way into almost an H pattern and then out through the objective lens. Thus you can make a smaller binocular if the power, these are both 8-power binoculars, and this one is a little bit smaller in size and in weight than this one, which is a traditional military binocular, but a poro prism nevertheless.
Now I notice this has a focus knob and this one doesn't.
That's correct. These binoculars are built for, you can literally drive your vehicle over these binoculars. They're built for strength first and durability. It's easier to make a waterproof, shockproof binocular without a center focusing mechanism, given that it's poro prism, this way. Now, they do make poro prisms with center focus, but the compromise there is that the waterproof integrity or the ability to keep water and moisture out and what have you is sacrificed.
Because you have one more moving part that goes through the outside of the body?
You can seal this for waterproofness much greater than if it were sitting on a central elevator moving up and down, which would have to be looser.
I see.
Now, in here, in a roof prism binoculars, almost all roof prism binoculars are focused internally. When I turn this focus wheel, the focusing mechanism moves back and forth internally, and there is no breakage, in effect, or place for the water vapor to, in effect, impregnate or pass into this binocular.
Okay.
Now, this binocular, I can focus to 6 feet,
right,
which is great for people who want to watch wildlife, butterflies, small animals and creatures up close. This would be very, very difficult and impractical to use for that purpose. This only works when you're looking at objects, let's say, 25 yards and greater. You set it on the optimum focal distance,
right,
and then you have acceptable focus, just like in a camera lens, acceptable focus from near to, let's say, 20 feet out to infinity.
Okay. Well, thank you much, Rob. I greatly appreciate the lesson on binoculars, and hope that our folks on GunsNameOfMag.com appreciate it as well.